Two, I want to do, before we get into other stuff, I do want to do two EI things that made me laugh. I mean, this fucking Fitzy thing is awesome. So Mike is, Mike's been defending this guy for years as a good comedian. What? So you have.
I have not.
Justin, has
I've
he?
I've defended
yes.
this guy.
He's funny. I bet you the first time we were talking to him, you're like, oh, his stand-up's kind of funny.
Right. I'm sure I did.
So he was on with Lou Maloney, and like I liked, so the producer of that show applied for this job, if you remember.
Yes, yeah.
We called it out, and I guess the people at the company weren't too happy with him.
Which one was
that's
that?
Surprising.
I don't know. What is
that? Tyler something?
Some drip. Yeah. So I like to think he was producing this segment and was like, go for
it. Just let it fly.
Good luck. I mean, listen, again, this is a comedian. His job is supposed to be to make people laugh. Now, we know he's awful. We know he's racist. We know that.
Well, that's the only part I defended.
That's a fact.
I'm not so sure.
I mean, he's just... And I saw him tweet this. I want to give... I've said this before. I want to give one of these master classes on how to get good ratings in radio. This morning, I saw this guy, Fitzy, whatever his Twitter account is. Somebody retweeted it. I think Jerry Thornton retweeted it, which is always a bad sign. Tweeted out, the other station in town, which I hate,
right,
says that fans don't care about the Patriots anymore. And a whole bunch of big crowds at practices... You will never win in the ratings by out fanboying the other station.
Right.
Okay, just remember that. Like, you might think that, you might get Twitter applause. People think you're a fucking child when you do that. I'm just letting you know that.
Yeah, well, if you're funny, you can, like that's what Barstool got known for, pretty much. Like that put him on the whole Goodell thing. And
yes, but there's a streak of rebellion to that. I mean, they went to prison.
Right. But my point is if you do it funny, like if you go to NFL headquarters and get arrested.
Correct. No, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
But when you say, you know, hey, how about the other stations? Is we don't, you know, we got fans. You know,
yeah,
it's like,
we're cool.
Yeah, like, what are you fucking doing?
We root for the home
team.
Yeah,
like, what are you, I'm not saying it to be purposely antagonistic or anything, but like this idea, and again, Dale used to do it, and manager used to tell me to do it all the time, like, oh, you could support the team. No, you don't have to. Now, if you think Brady got railroaded on Deflategate, you defend him.
Right.
But if you don't, you don't. This whole, like, we're part of... I see EI does it now. They're like, hashtag this guy to the All-Star game. Are you fucking children?
What's important?
It is important. So a caller got three... He was filling in, I guess, for Glenn, who must be done soon, I would think.
End of the summer, right?
Right.
They made him stick it out.
He'll probably want to do the Jimmy Fund for some reason. God bless him.
Glenn was drunk over the weekend, he tweeted.
He did?
His daughter got married.
Oh, I did see it. Yeah, that's right. I texted him. I saw his daughter got married. Yeah, that's true. Yes, she's taller than he is, I saw.
I mean, it's hard not to be, really.
4'8". So somebody got through about the current. I mean, again, you want to see a comedian. It's not often you get to see a comedian sort of spitballing live. Like, you never saw Pryor really do it. Murphy.
Right.
Carlin.
Yeah, in those times, you didn't have YouTube or Instagram.
They were just going to their stand-up act, you know?
Right.
And here's how a great comedic mind works.
Sissy, I'm wondering, like, if I'm Blue, maybe is in the wrong spot right now. I mean, is it the Red Sox fault? It seems like in Boston, they tend to put people in the wrong place. Like that sexual deviant Chris Curtis was in an ice cream truck today, you know, and I'm wondering what you have to say about that.
Ah.
You want to address that one?
What's that?
You want to address that one?
I'm going to go ahead and let if we dumped out of that one.
Hold on. You fucking loser. You pussy. Jesus Christ. Have some fucking fun with it, would you? I mean, make fun of us. Do something.
I'll continue my defense of him by saying he does come from the morning show. Or anything he said there never would have made it on air, you know?
Oh, my God. I mean, just make fun of us. Make fun of the caller. Do something. What the fuck?
The next part is even better, where he's like, he tries to recover.
It comes to a really good idea. I'll give him that. Good.
You want to address that one?
What's that?
You want to address that one?
I'm going to go ahead and let if we dumped out of that one, if we didn't, that's no big deal. That's fine.
Oh, yeah,
that was great. I appreciated that. I do love good ice cream. I wish an ice cream truck would pull up right now in front of the station. Lou, what would you like? What you want?
You want something? He put some crown on top of that shot.
Please turn it off. I mean, that's pathetic. What kind of ice cream would you like, Lou?
That is what is going through his mind there is like, what gets me in the least trouble
right,
here?
That's right. That's the way he thinks. That's the way you think in radio, I guess.
Yeah. Well, at least at EEI.
Suppose you're saying, yeah, Curtis a pervert. Like, just, yeah. Like, have some fun with it. I mean, do something.
I do love Lou hanging him out to dry. Like,
well, that's
go ahead.
I saw Lou get credit for that, too. That's also Lou afraid to swing at the pitch, too. Like, I think. Like, he's, you know, he's a bit of a pussy as well.
I suppose.
Keep in mind, this is a guy who said that was the worst thing that ever happened to the station.
But
and they are getting six times beaten by the station across the street.
But comparatively, at least he let it happen. You know, he doesn't step like Greg Hill or whoever would have stepped in and go, that's true. Yeah, you said the C word.
Yeah, but you're a pussy to your colleagues. Like, the listeners listening to that, they don't give a shit, and they're going to move on from it very quickly. So you're a pussy to your boss?
Who's a pussy?
Like, Fitzy. He wouldn't have fun with it just because his boss is going to yell at him about it? Like, who gives a shit?
No, he's afraid of everything. He's afraid of what the management's going to say. He wants to keep his job. He's probably a nice guy, but, he doesn't want to cause any... A great instinct in a comedian. Doesn't want to cause any trouble. Doesn't want to call. He's like Michael Che. He's the deleting pussy boy.
What is the level of yelling at? You know what I mean? Like, is his job threatened? And no, but what I'm saying is is he afraid?
But here's the thing, though. Maybe I know what you're saying, Mike. But like, he didn't do anything wrong there. Like the producer.
No, of course not.
If you're gonna play the asshole management radio game, the producer's in trouble there.
Right.
So like, he could play along with it even lightly.
But that's what I mean. Is like, if he does play along with it, they don't say like, "Art, now you're fired."
No. But he doesn't. But like, he doesn't want to get in any trouble, and he's also thinking like, "I don't want Curtis mad." You could just hear the fear and the
right.
Well, Curtis is the program director, right?
I don't know any idea, but
Tim Clark is Mark Hannon's old job, right?
Yeah, so I don't know if Ken or Chris or they. I don't know the program. I have no idea. I don't speak to either of them, but I don't talk to anybody there. Mutt doesn't know anything.
Funny thing, maybe I'm wrong about this, but I think that if it was any unrelated, like someone who has no ties to you or anything, and they make a joke about a guy being an ice cream truck being a pervert, I don't think he's afraid to respond to that.
But you're forgetting something else.
That's the weird part.
There's also a chance, and maybe I'm being too tough on Lou, I don't know. There's a chance that management was like, after this picture stuff, like, don't fucking say anything about this.
Right.
You know?
Don't say anything about Curtis at all.
Right.
Yeah.
And then, of course, they go and have Curtis an ice cream truck on a Friday. So it's like I don't know what you expect
just
people.
Just a weird move.
Like, I don't know what you expect people to say. Like, I don't know, you know. And then, one caller gets through. And again, I don't know what Fitzy can say, though. But you can say something to make fucking Lou laugh. And then, like Dave said, then you're done. Like, then you just move on. And we play. And we're like, oh, good for Fitzy. And then it's over. I feel like I'm the program director of that station. Like, they purposely are afraid to do stuff because of us.
You're the almost the anti-program.
Correct.
Like, they try to when you zig, they zag.
Right. Yeah, it's weird. It's just strange. I don't know. But yeah, that did make me laugh. And again, it's just that comedic instinct of, I'm just gonna wait for the. I would imagine saying I'm just gonna wait for this to. It's again, we've had calls in the past on the old show where somebody said something you just can't say on the air.
Right.
Like Matt Damon was calling or something. You know, one of those horrible things. But like, you just kind of wait or whatever. You laugh or you say, what are you doing? And then you keep going. You keep going. Like, you don't stop. Stop. I'll just wait for this one to.
It never fucking ends moment. That's where he literally doesn't know what to say. And he just like, Lou, you got anything?
Lou, ice cream. What kind of ice cream would you like? Like, oh my God.
That was worse than when you take a bathroom break and Mike and I have to talk for 3 minutes and Justin chimes in too.
What do we do?
I'm glad I've never heard that. Yeah. Jesus.